I'm Mariah Bogus, and I'm the deer biologist for the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission. I'm also a very serious hunter, and on a March 31st, chronic wasting disease was first confirmed in North Carolina, which is very concerning to me as a hunter, a biologist, and I'm sure to everyone else. So chronic wasting disease is a very slow building disease in the environment and in the whitetail deer population, and it has long-term permanent consequences for the future of whitetail deer management. We need to make choices now to better improve deer populations for the future, our future generations. This coming year, when hunters take to the field in Yadkin County, everything's going to seem like normal, but there will be sick deer spreading this disease in the environment, and we need to address this. This year, we want hunters in the field harvesting deer just the same as they always have. In fact, we want hunters to take more deer than normal. If you've taken one deer in the past, take an extra one, take an extra two, and submit them to us for testing so that we can combat this disease. I want to address another disease that CWD is often confused with, and that's hemorrhagic disease, also known as EHD or blue tongue. Now, hemorrhagic disease has been endemic to the southeast for centuries. As long as we've been studying deer, there have been these cyclical outbreaks of hemorrhagic disease where we see many deer dying at once along rivers or along ponds where there's standing water. Hemorrhagic disease does not pose a significant threat to the future of deer populations because deer are adapted to it. But there's some differences between EHD and CWD. EHD is not always fatal. Some deer survive, and those that survive have immunity to the disease, which guards them from future outbreaks. With CWD, every single deer that gets infected will eventually die from the disease. Additionally, as CWD is introduced to a population, it slowly builds in the landscape. That's because CWD is caused by prions, which are misfolded proteins that are not alive. Therefore, they can't be killed, and over time, in a population, they increase in prevalence so that a higher and higher percentage of that population is infected with the disease. This is especially impactful to whitetail deer populations because deer that contract CWD have an effective expiration date of 16 to 24 months, at which point they will die. Across the southeast and North Carolina, our average fawn recruitment rate is 50%. So this means it takes 2 does per year to produce 1 fawn. Or in other words, it takes 2 years for a doe to replace herself. In the long run, as CWD infection rates increase, we know that deer lifespans will become shorter and shorter as they catch the disease earlier in life and they will die sooner. In the future, when does are contracting CWD as fawns, they will only have 1 or 2 full breeding seasons to reproduce before they die, which means that some deer will not be able to successfully replace themselves, driving down the population over time. It's important to realize that this will take decades to see the full effects, as the prevalence of CWD slowly builds in the population. So this isn't going to happen overnight, but it underlines the importance of us taking action now for future generations in the management of these populations. So what can we do to address CWD? There's 3 main points. First, we need to test for this disease to know where it is on the landscape so that we can address it. Secondly, we can help by not giving this disease a ride. And this is best avoided by not moving live or sick deer that may be infected and spread the disease outside of the infected area. And lastly, while we know that deer will interact and naturally transmit the disease, we can reduce spread of the disease by eliminating unnecessary feeding. To address chronic wasting disease, we've implemented special regulations for the 2022 season. First, we've established a primary surveillance area in southern Surrey County and northern Yadkin County, and established a secondary surveillance area in the surrounding counties. Across both of these surveillance areas, the rehabilitation of deer fawns is strictly prohibited. Furthermore, the feeding of deer between January 2nd and August 31st is also prohibited. Inside the primary surveillance area, all hunter-harvested deer taken during the black powder and gun hunting season must be submitted for mandatory testing. Additionally, carcasses may not be transported outside of the primary surveillance area except for deboned meat, caped hides, antlers, antlers attached to clean skull plates, clean lower jaw bones, finished taxidermy products, or carcasses or carcass parts that are double bagged and transported directly to a Servant Health Cooperator in Yadkin or Surrey County. Inside of the secondary surveillance area, all hunter-harvested deer taken during black powder season and the first complete week of the gun hunting season must be submitted for mandatory testing. Additionally, carcasses may not be transported outside the secondary surveillance area except for deboned meat, caped hides, antlers, antlers attached to clean skull plates, clean lower jaw bones, and finished taxidermy products. For more information on CWD and how you can help us address this important threat to North Carolina's whitetail deer herd, go to ncwildlife.org/CWD.